Man, I swear that I'm a real one, I ain't never losing. And now I'm so caught in spin, but they don't never do shit. I'm in these streets, this shit is real, man, I ain't picking choosing. I got a year before I die, I'm focused on the music. Man, I swear that I'm a real one, I ain't never losing. And now I'm so caught in spin, but they don't never do shit. I'm in these streets, this shit is real, man, I ain't picking choosing. I got a year before I die.
Finished recording the podcast on Discord server with Abhinav. You know, my conversation with Abhinav was short. However, my conversation with the people on his community was insane. We spoke for over 1 hour. People were interacting constantly, asking a lot of questions. Moreover, they were asking a lot of questions with the businesses I was personally involved. They wanted to know more about Make Me Garden, Shop Refined, and I don't know, I got a lot of people asking a lot of deep detailed questions about these two businesses, and I felt genuinely happy. You know, it's usually the customers that I deal with giving me reviews or interacting about my business. Sorry. But you know, people of my age don't do that, and being there in a community where you have people genuinely interested in what you have to sell or what you've learned through being involved in two startups, I don't know, man. I feel like that was very interesting. I just enjoyed it a lot. Now, I guess community building is something that I really, really have to look into. It's weird. These people who are on this Discord server, they were asking detailed questions about gardening. And I genuinely think that people really have questions like this, and it would be a really good opportunity for me to be in a situation to, you know, answer these questions that they're having. I may not be able to answer all of them, but I definitely could answer most of them, since that's a business I'm involved in. Not just gardening. I wanted to do this for Refined as well, and I don't know, not just for both of that, I might just do it for just my personal brand too, just communicating with my followers and seeing or finding out if they have some question or query that I could help them out with, because that is something I enjoy doing and that is something that gives me happiness. I don't know, man, I'm really, really happy after that ending part of me interacting with Abhinav Arora's community. Oh my god, they're so fucking good. I still can't put it in words, the amount of questions they asked about my business. See, I'm so excited because nobody ever asked me these many questions about the business I am doing. So when I see people who are genuinely interested in knowing what exactly am I doing, I'm the happiest guy out there, because I would love to speak out about what the fuck I'm doing, man. That's basically the whole point of this YouTube channel. So yeah, there's that. And as a matter of fact, I wanted to speak about change. Today I was having a conversation with a friend of mine where he was saying that change is something that just doesn't happen. And you know, that's when this came out of me, and I was like, change is fucking inevitable. You cannot do anything about it. And the next thing he said was, what do you mean change is inevitable? It doesn't make sense. So when I say change is inevitable, what that basically means is, if you're not doing anything to, you know, improve that present situation, it doesn't mean that you're going to stay in the same level. What change is inevitable means is, if you're not doing anything to change this present situation, you're not going to stay in the same level. You're only going to degrade. If you're doing something to improve, you're going to upgrade. If you're doing nothing whatsoever, you're not going to stay in the same position. You're only going to degrade. It's basically like, you know, you might learn cricket and you might get really good at it. And, you know, you'll be playing really good cricket for a while. But then you stop learning cricket, you stop playing cricket, and you just sit. it doesn't mean that when you resume back this, when you go back to playing cricket, you'll be the best player in the world or you'll be good at it. You're obviously going to suck because you've done nothing about it. You've done nothing about improving that skill. So, you know, the old skill whatsoever you had, the muscle memory of these skills, it falls down. So, you know, when I say change is inevitable, if you're doing nothing to improve yourself, it doesn't mean you're staying here. You're downgrading. That's the whole concept of change is inevitable. If you're working on something, you're getting better. If you're not, you're getting worse. You're not staying the same. So that's basically what change is inevitable. That is basically what I mean by change is inevitable. You better do something about it, man. It's like, you know, if you did one thing for probably 6 months straight or 1 year straight, and you know for a fact just doing this one thing will improve your life, why the fuck wouldn't you do it? So this one thing, I'll give you an example. For me, it was reading 10 pages of a book. When somebody told me that, why the fuck couldn't you read 10 pages a day, knowing that in a year, you'll be far more knowledgeable than where you started. And that made a lot of sense. So, you know, when you know doing one thing consistently for a long period of time is going to improve you or improve your life, like, why the fuck wouldn't you do that? Isn't that sensible for you to do it? I don't know, if you ask me, that's the most sensible thing for anyone to do. One simple thing consistently for a long period of time for a better life. That's a fair trade-off, man. Anyways, it's 9:20 and it's way past my bedtime and I'm not even sleepy because I'm fucking happy with the live stream which just happened, man. It's so fucking good. It's nice.